Okay, this is what you have to do in order to form the table. Here you have the standard ribbon tabs, but once you click on the table, two more ribbon tabs appear, design and layout. On design ribbon tab, you can select several options such as table styles. In table styles, you can define different table styles that automatically adjust colors, borders, and everything you need for your table. Also, if I highlight any section on the table, in this case the first row, I can specify shading colors or fill colors, as I'm doing right now. Moreover, if you highlight again any section on the table, in the layout ribbon tab, you can specify options like merge cells that automatically combines all cells that you have selected. Alignment is also available, and height and width options as well. In this case, I'm going to adjust my cell size in 1 centimeter height. Well, to conclude with this short explanation, let's learn how to split cells. If I click on any cell that I want, by clicking on the split cells option, you can specify the number of columns or rows you need. Well, that's all for now. Now, let's learn how to split text into columns. The first step is to select or highlight the text that I want to split. Afterwards, in Page Layout Ribbon tab, in Columns option, I must click in More Columns option. The pop-up window that appears has several options. For example, the presets that I have, 1, 2, 3 columns, the spacing between columns, width, and also if I want to specify equal column width or not. One more thing, line between, check the preview, and that's it. Now you have your text into two columns. In order to conclude with this explanation, let's add a subtitle or a title if you want, and that's it. Hope you enjoy it. Easy, right? And don't forget to keep practicing. Well, here we go with some explanation about how to insert images. On the Insert Ribbon tab, you must click on the Pictures option. Now, you select the image you want to insert. Afterwards, you have your image and now you see that a new ribbon appears, Format. Format has several options. In this case, we are going to start using the size option. Here you can specify height, width, according to elements such as aspect ratio. I'm going to adjust the height, and if the aspect ratio is thick, automatically my width adjusts. I'm going to keep the aspect ratio on, and that's it. Now, for more options, you can align according to the paragraph to the left, center, or right, or if you click in layout options, you can specify some text wrapping options, as you can see. Well, easy, right? Hope you enjoy it. Keep practicing.